الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وتم التسليم على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه من والاه. وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. وبعد، who said this topic before?
Okay. This is a very controversial topic, actually.
Very controversial. It's a topic that, since I've been in 15 years of my deen, alhamdulillah, it's been a very controversial topic in the sense that it's caused disunity and also being a very problematic subject. This is one of the foundations of our deen, al-wala wal-bara. People usually translate it as love and hate for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but mainly it's association and disassociation for the sake of Allah. So you make wala with those who are taking Allah and Rasul and Ahl Sunnah wa Jama'ah in its entirety as their wala, and you make bara, you dissociate yourself from those who think they're upon al-haq. And this is why when people of knowledge speak about the diseases of the ummah in regards to the different groups that there are amongst us today, and the mindsets and the different kinds of beliefs that people have, the understanding of the deen is vital because of that, because of the fact that you need to have a foundation of your deen. Over the last 3 to 5 years, maybe 6 years, no, actually about 8 to 9 years, there's been a lot of fitna in London regarding voting, democracy, Muslims taking on board the vocabulary of the kuffar, namely calling each other terrorists and squealing to the British government, and some even dare to go and be bold as to say, "I told you about these people." These people, yani, they call Muslims, so-called shuyukh and imams, are saying, "I told you about these people." Telling the British government about these people, yani. That's their rhetorics. My blood boils when I hear Muslims speak like this. It just shows the ignorance and the ignorance, in the sense they have no knowledge in regards to this. And personally speaking, I don't care about anyone who has a whole heap of knowledge, as they say. It's what you do with that knowledge that you respect. Because, you know, you may have someone who's, you know, studied in Medina and studied here and everywhere else, but he believes certain erroneous ideas about the deen, and there's no understanding about al-wala wal-bara. Al-wala wal-bara is such an important topic, especially now, that every single Muslim should embark on this phase, or this variable of the deen. So you know where you stand with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm not talking about just praying 5 times a day and doing your sunnah muqaddah and everything else you do. You could do all that. You could do hajj every year. You could do jihad fi sabilillah. But if your aqidah is not straight, you can forget about it. It's just not going to work. It's vital that you understand the difference between iman and Islam and ihsan, the difference between uluhiyya, rubbiyya, asma'i wa sifat, and tawhid al-hakimiyya. Who's heard of tawhid al-hakimiyya? That Allah's governance on earth. And if people say, "Yeah, well, you know, I believe in Allah. I believe Allah created us in stages," as says in the Quran, that we came from apes, you know, in stages. And you have to seek refuge in Allah from this. Because anyone of us here can believe like this, with a twist. If you take off the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm just making by default. You're praying 5 times a day, okay? You're praying 5 times a day. You're doing everything you can, but your aqidah is not spot on. Because of that fact, you believe that we can get the Sharia by voting. You believe that there is democracy in Islam. Okay, there are democracy amongst Muslims, as there are nationalism and every other schism, but there is none of that in Islam. Islam, there is Islam, Allah, Rasulullah, Kitabullah, and that's it. There is nothing else. You have no right to bring anything else and sort of spice up the deen because you don't believe on certain aspects because your iman or your intellectualization of the deen cannot handle some aspects of the deen. You have no right to do this. No right at all. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that once there is a hukum being made, the believers have no right to have an opinion on that matter at all. And I don't care who you are, where you come from. Once Allah and Rasul said something, that's it. And you know the story of Umar al-Khattab where the man went to Abu Bakr and said, I want your opinion on a certain matter. Then he went to Umar al-Khattab and asked for the opinion. He said, did you get an opinion from Rasulullah? He said, yeah. He said, wait here, I'm going to get my opinion, I'm going to come back and I'll give you my opinion. He came and took his head off. He said, that's my opinion. This is as deep as it gets. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a spokesman, is a messenger chosen by the Lord of the universe, Rabbul Alameen, to be a man on earth, given to him some powers of miracles to show people that he is a prophet, to guide people from the shackles of their own desires and beliefs to attach themselves back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Chosen by the one who created everything and everyone, seen and unseen, and said, you go and spread my message and tell them. And even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that if you commit shirk, I'll wipe away your deeds, even to him. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And yet we have Muslims who hear Quran and Sunnah, and it's by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah gives you makes you hear some verses of the Quran, or someone teaches you something, and then you accept it wholeheartedly. That's a mercy from Allah. That's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because he can easily close your heart and you can think something else, as most people do. People say, Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in, and they go to the grave and ask for something from the person in the grave. And no matter what you say to this person, they call you Wahhabi. Instead of taking the truth, when the truth comes, they label you. Because they can't handle the truth, it's too bitter. Like a child doesn't like the medicine that's good for him or her. And living in this kind of society now, we are in the pit of darkness, in complete darkness now. And the only light is Al-Islam. The only light. And we sin. Nobody escapes from sin. Nobody. We all are sinners. And our only way out is to turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And never despair of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No matter what sin you do. Never. You continue learning what Iman is, Islam is, Ihsan is, what is Allah as a Lord and Allah as a deity, how to believe Allah as a Lord and how to believe Allah as a deity, and all the concepts of the deen, al-wala wal-bara, shurut la ilaha illallah, the conditions of la ilaha illallah, we did last time, very briefly, very briefly.